Insulin glargine is a modified form of long-acting or basal insulin used to control hyperglycemia in diabetes mellitus. In this video, let's find found. What is insulin glargine? What is insulin glargine used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking insulin glargine? How does insulin glargine work? How to use insulin glargine? What is insulin glargine? Insulin glargine, sold under the brand name Lantus among others, is a long-acting modified form of medical insulin used in the management of type I and type 2 diabetes. It is injected just under the skin. Effects generally begin an hour after use. Insulin glargine was approved for medical use in the United States in 2000. It is on the World Health Organization's list of essential medicines. In 2020, it was the 32nd most commonly prescribed medication in the United States, with more than 17 million prescriptions. In July 2021, the U.S. Food and Drug Administration, FDA, approved an interchangeable biosimilar insulin product called Semglee, insulin glargine yfgn, for the treatment of diabetes. What is insulin glargine used for? Insulin glargine is indicated to improve glycemic control in adults and pediatric patients with type 1 diabetes mellitus and in adults with type 2 diabetes mellitus. Contraindication. You should not use insulin glargine if you are allergic to insulin, or if you are having an episode of hypoglycemia, low blood sugar, or diabetic ketoacidosis. Call your doctor for treatment. Insulin glargine is not approved for use by anyone younger than 6 years old, and some brands are for use only in adults. What is insulin glargine used for? Insulin glargine is indicated to improve glycemic control in adults and pediatric patients with type 1 diabetes mellitus and in adults with type 2 diabetes mellitus. Contraindication. You should not use insulin glargine if you are allergic to insulin, or if you are having an episode of hypoglycemia, low blood sugar, or diabetic ketoacidosis. Call your doctor for treatment. Insulin glargine is not approved for use by anyone younger than 6 years old, and some brands are for use only in adults. Mechanism of action. Insulin glargine binds to the insulin receptor, IR, a heterotetrameric protein consisting of 2 extracellular alpha units and 2 transmembrane beta units. The binding of insulin to the alpha subunit of IR stimulates the tyrosine kinase activity intrinsic to the beta subreceptor. The bound receptor autophosphorylates and phosphorylates numerous intracellular substrates such as insulin receptor substrates, IRS, proteins, CBL, APS, SHC, and GAB1. Activation of these proteins leads to the activation of downstream signaling molecules including PI kinase and ACT. ACT regulates the activity of glucose transporter 4, GLUT4, and protein kinase C, PKC, both of which play critical roles in metabolism. Insulin glargine is completely soluble at pH 4, the pH of administered solution, and has low solubility at logical pH 7.4. Upon subcutaneous injection, the solution is neutralized, resulting in the formation of microprecipitates. Small amounts of insulin glargine are released from microprecipitates, giving the drug a relatively constant concentration over time profile over 24 hours with no pronounced peak. This release mechanism allows the drug to mimic basal insulin levels within the body. Dose. Type 1 diabetes mellitus. Long-acting basal insulin indicated to improve glycemic control. Initial dose. For insulin-naive patients. Start 1/3 of total daily insulin dose, use remaining 2/3 of daily insulin dose on short-acting, premealin. Usual initial dose range, 0.2 to 0.4 units/kg, optimal glucose lowering effect may take 5 days to fully manifest, and the first insulin glargine dose may be insufficient to cover metabolic needs in the first 24 hours of use. Titrate insulin glargine instructions. And adjust co-administered glucose-lowering therapies per standard of care. See dosing considerations and administration. Type 2 diabetes mellitus. Long-acting basal insulin indicated to improve glycemic control. Initial dose. For insulin-naive patients. start 0.2 units/kg qday. If necessary, adjust dosage of other antidiabetic drugs when starting insulin glargine to minimize the risk of hypoglycemia. See dosing considerations and administration. Safety advice. Advice and warnings for the use of insulin glargine during pregnancy. FDA pregnancy category C risk cannot be ruled out. Dose. Type 1 diabetes mellitus. Long-acting basal insulin indicated to improve glycemic control. Initial dose. For insulin-naive patients. Start 1/3 of total daily insulin dose. Use remaining 2/3 of daily insulin dose on short-acting, premealin. Usual initial dose range, 0.2 to 0.4 units/kg. Optimal glucose lowering effect may take 5 days to fully manifest, and the first insulin glargine dose may be insufficient to cover metabolic needs in the first 24 hours of use. Titrate insulin glargine instructions and adjust co-administered glucose-lowering therapies per standard of care. See dosing considerations and administration. Type 2 diabetes mellitus. Long-acting basal insulin indicated to improve glycemic control. Initial dose. For insulin-naive patient. Start 0.2 units/kg qday. If necessary, adjust dosage of other antidiabetic drugs when starting insulin glargine to minimize the risk of hypoglycemia. See dosing considerations and administration.